Hi friends, so we have now entered into our second milestone. In this step what we are doing is, so we have this hood which we had taken off earlier from our vehicle. We will put some LED lights on this hood so that when our car is ready it looks awesome. And you may wonder that what is the importance of these LEDs, because they will give us some visual signs and we will program our car in such a manner that those visual signs will tell us the status of the car. And the reason we took this task before other tasks is also to familiarize ourselves with this Raspberry Pi card and some Python programming, because we both are new to Raspberry Pi as well as Python programming. So we thought that let's first start this activity and learn some Python and some Raspberry Pi wiring and interfacing, and this will prepare us for some advanced tasks which are coming up in the next milestones. So what we have done today is we have taken a Raspberry Pi card and we have connected this Raspberry Pi card with 10 LEDs. There are two LEDs of white color for the headlights, and we have got four yellow LEDs for the turn indicators for left and right, and we've got two red color LEDs for the brake lights at the back, and we've got two blue lights also for emergency signals. The challenge that we had in this particular activity was to program these LEDs independent of each other. So when we will give you a demo now, it will appear that this is a very simple task, but actually it is not. The reason it is not an easy task is that once the wiring is done with Raspberry Pi, then we have to program each LED as an independent programming object. So in Python we have got this object oriented programming, and what we have done is that we have treated each LED of these 10 LEDs as an independent class or as an independent object, and we have controlled these LEDs independent of each other in an asynchronous manner. For that to happen, we had to learn a lot of threading and parallel programming in Python, and we also learned that the latest version of Python, which is something about 3.4, has a new library called Async.io, which actually provides infinite loops to run in parallel without the main program having to wait for those loops to finish. So after a lot of R&D, we made it work, and now we will give you a demo of how it works. Once this entire circuit has been completed, what we will do, we will dismantle it, and then we will put the LEDs at the right places on this vehicle and wire them up again, and then again connect back to Raspberry Pi. We are using 10 general purpose input output ports of Raspberry Pi for this purpose, and all the programming has been done in Python. And now let's see the demo, and I'll bring the camera closer so that you can see exactly how it is working. Before I bring the camera closer, just want to let you know that Raspberry Pi is connected to my home Wi-Fi router, and my laptop here is also connected to my Wi-Fi router. So the Raspbian operating system, which is running inside this Raspberry Pi, is connected to the Wi-Fi network, and I will connect from my laptop to Raspberry Pi using SSH server. So I have a SSH client installed on my laptop. From there I will do a SSH login into my Raspberry Pi over Wi-Fi network, and I will execute the Python program remotely. So let's see the demo and bring the camera closer. Okay, so now hopefully you can see the LEDs from a close distance. So these are the LEDs. We have used a breadboard to temporarily wire them up. We are using the current limiting resistance because the Raspberry Pi supplies 3.3 volt to the LEDs, but I think the operating voltage of these LEDs is approximately 2 volts. So we have to put a current limiting resistance in series with LEDs so that any excess current is drained by these resistance and they don't end up either burning the LEDs or burning our Raspberry Pi port. We have a program already loaded on Raspberry Pi. All this program that we are writing, we will also put on GitHub, so that, and we'll provide a link below our video so that you can download the program and try yourself also. So now let me just start this program. So I'm giving a command from my laptop. That command is actually being executed on the Raspberry Pi, and now it starts. As you can see now, these are the headlight LEDs. These are the brake lights. These are the four turn indicators, and these are the blue emergency light indicators. If you notice carefully, that all these LEDs are actually blinking in a different manner. For example, the blue ones are giving a strobe effect, whereas the yellow ones are going to blink at a set interval, and the red ones will also blink at a set interval, and the interval is also configurable. So what we have done is, in our Python program, we have written different methods. So there is a method for strobing a certain LED, there is a method for blinking LEDs, and there is a method to just simply switch on and switch off an LED, and those are parameterized. So when the main program will ask a certain LED to either switch on, switch off, or blink, all it has to do is pass the pin number on which a certain LED is wired, and let the program know at what interval it should blink, if it should blink, or if it should just remain on for a certain time. It just has to tell the program to switch on an LED by the pin number. So this is our complete. This completes our second milestone, and we will now dismantle this, and we will put all these LEDs on our box, and we'll come back and we'll give you a demo of how it looks once these all LEDs are mounted on our vehicle. So stay connected and look out for the next portion. Okay, friends. So here we are. What we have done now is we have mounted all the LEDs on our vehicle's body. As you can see, the two headlight LEDs have gone into the original place where there was a place for headlights. Then we have got the turn indicators. So these are front, left and right indicators. We have put two hazard lights on the top, and we have put the brake lights, the red color ones, and the rear left and right turn indicators also. So all these have been now mounted. Under the hood you can see that, can you hold it? Okay, you can see that all the wiring, there's a lot of wiring here. So we have used one common ground for all the LEDs and used 10 individual wires for all the 10 LEDs. And they are now, so we have labeled here according to which LED. For example, this one is left left blue. Basically, the left blue is the top one, and similarly we have labeled turn. So this is rear right turn, so RRTU. So this way we have coded so that in case in future we have to take them off for some repair or maintenance, then we can easily put them back without having to refer to our software. And you can see that we have used a color coded wire also to sort of make a jumper between the vehicle wiring and the Raspberry Pi wiring. So we have insulated all the connectors so that they don't connect with each other or cause any kind of short circuit, and they will also ensure that during the movement of the vehicle they will not come out.
because this yellow shrink tube will hold them together. This is our original wiring which we showed you a little earlier, where you can see that Raspberry Pi 10 digital outputs have been used to control the 10 LED lights, and there is one common ground which we have used. Besides that, there is a Python program running in Raspberry Pi which is currently operating all the LEDs. So next milestone, we will now start hooking the camera and the ultrasonic sensor, which is mounted on the front of the vehicle, so that the car can see what is going on the road and accordingly take some decisions. So we'll see you soon in the next video.